friends, welcome to Suni Art. This is Suni. Hello, 大家好，欢迎来到 Suni Art， 我是 Suni。今天呢，想跟大家分享呢，就是这个、玻璃瓶的拼贴。Today I want to share with you this decoupage on the glass. Okay, this one is a vase, glass vase. Okay, I also do some crackle effect.这个呢是一个那个花瓶，其实我也做了一点这个裂纹的效果，然后使用我们最新系列的拼贴纸 ，and I use our latest series of decoupage paper, so decoupage paper can be used on the glass surface also. 所以呢，拼贴纸呢，拼贴专用纸呢，也是可以做在这个玻璃上的。然后呢，这个是我们的水转印纸 ，this one is a water slide image transfer paper. Okay, today I will share with you this project. Okay, using limited color.So our color is very versatile and can be used on any surface. 我们的那个亚克力颜料是无毒水溶性的，可以用在任何的素材上面。So the color is the acrylic paint is a non-toxic and water-based. Okay, so today I will going to show you this project. And also, all the material needed, actually, I will post in the description section.还有呢，全部的那个所需要用到的材料呢，其实我都有放在了描述栏。So when you go to my YouTube, like for example, this one is, one of my tutorial. Okay, so you click to the tutorial and you click here. Can you see this button? 你可以看到这个键吗？所以呢，你就去到了我的那个视频，然后呢，你就按里面，你就按这个 ，then you press this button, just press.Okay, then you will go to see, and you get to see all the information there. 你按进去过后呢，你就可以看到全部的资料了。你看这边呢，我有写得很清楚，所需要用到的工具和材料。And you also can see all the material and tools needed for this particular project.所以呢，这件作品呢所需要的工具和材料都有在这里了，这里也有连接 and here also with the link that where you can get this material 这边呢也有连接，是产品的连接，你如何可以购买得到。 OK, 有任何疑问呢，你们都可以留言给我，我会尽快回复你。 If you have any problem, I can, you just leave me a message and I try to reply you as quickly as possible. OK, so let us start now. 现在呢我们就来开始啦。So this glass actually I bought from IKEA. 这个是我从那个宜家买回来的。所以很多人不晓得这个纸要怎么如何处理。Then a lot of you don't know how to clean this paper, how to remove it. Actually, you have to blow dry with the hair dryer. Okay. 其实呢很简单，就是用那个吹风机把它吹久，让它的那个胶融化就可以了。So it will melt the glue, then easy to lift. Okay, I blow dry first.Roll. Okay, then after that, just remove. 过后吹了过后呢，你就把它撕上来就 OK 了。You see, it's much easier to remove after you blow dry. Okay, 吹了过后呢，其实会这样子比较容易清理，比较容易撕上来。Okay, then after that, we have to clean this glass with the alcohol.To clean all the dust, okay, because the water cannot clean so well. 因为水呢没有那么容易把它清理干净，所以呢我都会用这个酒精来把它清理一下。如果有酒精呢，你就可以买这个酒精海绵。If you don't have the alcohol, you can buy the alcohol swab. It's the same. Okay, just spray all over. 就是把它喷上来，然后呢，你用那个干的纸把它擦干就可以了。And use the dry tissue or the kitchen towel to clean to dry it. 然后呢，就这样子擦一下，用那个餐巾纸。Okay, then blow dry, then we can start. 吹干了过后呢，我们就可以开始了。这个步骤很重要。This step is important to clean all the dust and some very oily part that you cannot clean with the water. 因为有一些它很油性嘛，太油的话呢，有时候纸张贴不上或者是纸粘不上，我们就这样子清就比较好。Now I blow dry first. Now we have to apply a layer of all multi-surface sealer. 然后呢，我们要上一层底剂，因为呢，这个玻璃呢是无孔表面，你直接上颜料呢，颜料很难附着上去。所以如果你有跟我之前的视频呢，你就会晓得我们都会涂一层这个。Okay, if you follow my earlier tutorial that you will know, all this non-porous surface, the paint cannot be stick on. Okay, after some time, it will peel off. That's why we need to apply a layer of sealer. okay, then to receive the pain later. 所以呢，我们涂这个底剂呢，是让它等下可以接受那个颜料。然后我很喜欢用这个牌子，美国牌子这个 Heritage 的这个底剂，这个底剂非常好用，因为它很适合用在任何的素材上面。I like to use this, this Heritage Sealer very much because it's very versatile and can use on any surface. Okay, so actually you don't use much. It's very safe. 它不会用很多，其实是蛮省的，就把它倒在这个容器里。然后呢，我会用一个比较软毛的笔。And I use a soft brush because I don't want to see a lot of brush mark just all over.Okay, no need to apply so much. After dry, it's transparent. 干了过后呢，其实是透明的，不用担心，所以 no need to worry, okay? Just apply like that, you see? It's transparent. And after blow dry, you can immediately apply the paint, no need to wait for 24 hours. 吹干了过后呢，你就可以直接上颜色了，不用等24小时，所以是蛮 okay 的。Just like that. Okay, one layer, you see, I pour too much. 你看我都倒的太多了，这样子就 okay 了。Okay, done. Then I blow dry first. 然后呢，就先吹干。Okay, you see, after blow dry is transparent. 你看吹干了呢，它是透明的哈、哦，没有不用担心。You see, it can scratch, but I just want to share with you. Actually, after you paint on this sealer, then it's easier to paint the acrylic paint. 只是想让你知道呢，你涂了这个底剂过后呢，你上那个亚克力颜料就比较容易。但是如果你没有这个底剂呢，没有关系，你可以用这个白色的石膏打上去。If you don't have the sealer, never mind. You also can use the white gesso, but you have to use the dauber.Use a sponge, the dauber, to dab on it evenly. Okay, 如果你没有这个底剂呢，没有关系，你就用这个白色的石膏底剂来用海绵把它拍上去就 OK 了。Then now I continue because I want to do the crackle effect. So I want a dark color base. 因为我想做裂纹嘛，所以我的底呢一定是要黑色，比较深色的。做裂纹呢，有大致上呢，我们会用两个颜色。如果你的底色是深色，上面就会要浅色。If you do a cracker, you need two contrast color. If your base is dark color, you see the line inside the crack is dark color, right? Then the color on top should be a slightly lighter color. 所以你的上面的颜色呢就要浅色。你看到这些缝呢是深色的，这样子它的上面呢就要浅色。所以呢，今天我想延伸用回这一组颜色。Today I want still to continue using this series of color because my new series of paper, you can only use few color to match the paper, so that you no need to invest so many color.我们这一组的拼贴纸呢，其实你用几款颜色呢就可以做出很多很多不同的。组合不同的创作 So just few colors Then you can come up with Thousands of design Okay, your own design of art piece Like I show you Here, you see I use a few colors like melon Antique white, soft white Okay, these are the paper That our new paper launching This one is a new paper所以你看到这里的颜色和这里的颜色都是一样的 And this one also using the same series of color Okay, it's the vintage blue melon Then the antique white and the linen Okay, you see with the same series similar series of the paper This one also I using the vintage blue linen antique white Okay, it's the same color series 这个也是一样的我也用类似同样的颜色你也可以做很多的作品出来This one also the same series of a color, just I change different design of the paper. 这个呢也是同样的色系 ，OK， 只是我换了不同的图纸。所以我们的图纸呢，就是衬几个颜色也很好看了，也很丰富。So just a few colors and with our paper, you can come up with a lot of designs. OK, let us continue now. 现在呢，我们来接续吧。这样子呢，我就想用我们的那个 linen 的颜色了来做底色。Then I want to use the linen as the base color. So, use the dauber to dab all over the surface. 然后就用海绵棒呢，把整个瓶子呢拍上这个颜色，底部就不需要了。It's up to you if you want to do on the bottom.你就自由啦，如果你要也可以，不要也没有关系，我就不要，因为我怕它每次 每一次我们会放着它会颜料会给我们弄走嘛。So I'm not going to dab the bottom because yeah, we are always put on the table, then the color might fade or might peel off. So just like that, just dab all over. After that, blow dry, okay?Okay, after very blow dry already, you can apply two layers because I found that one layer is enough, is opaque enough, then I don't do the second layer. 你可以涂两层，因为我觉得一层已经很饱和了，我就不涂第二层了。Okay, then now I will apply a layer of the faux art crackle. This crackle is inexpensive, but the effect is very, very stunning.这个 faux art 的这个劣迹呢，它不贵，但是呢，它出来的效果非常非常的好。I like this crackle effect very much.So, let us apply a layer of this crackle. So, how thick and how thin of the crackle you apply will determine the quick crack is big or thick. 所以呢，这个劣迹呢，你涂的透还是薄呢，也会影响你的那个裂纹是粗还是细。Okay, like for example, I show you the sample. Like for example, if I have a thicker, crackle medium, then you will have a big crack, and also the paint that you apply on top will determine the crack also. If I apply a very thick layer of paint, then you will see a big crack, okay? But if I apply a thin layer of paint, then you will see a very fine crack, a very small crack. See? Very small and fine crack because I apply a thin layer of paint.所以呢，那个劣迹的本身呢，会影响你的裂纹是粗还是细。如果你的劣迹很厚，或者是你的颜料也很多，这样子呢，你就会有很粗的裂纹出来，就比较大的裂纹。如果你的颜料很稀、很薄、很少，哦，你的劣迹也很少，这样子你出来的效果就会这样子比较小的裂纹。OK, 这个裂纹呢其实是用海绵创建出来的。And this kind of crackle effect, like round shape, right, is created by using the sponge, OK, 是用海绵创建的。But if you want a different kind of crack, then you have to use a brush. I have this tutorial also in my YouTube channel, you can go and check. This one is using sponge to create, OK, this different one.所以呢，这个是用海绵来创建的，那个裂纹。这个是用笔刷 ，This one is using the brush. Okay, so you can check my YouTube channel. I have a video special teaching you how to do the crack. 我有一个视频呢，是在这个 YouTube 呢特别做出来，是教你们如何处理这个不同的裂纹。So you have different kind of crack. You can create different kind of crack. You can check my video. 所以你可以去看一下我那个视频，有教你如何处理不同的那个裂纹。Okay, then we apply, I already pour here, then apply a layer of the cracker medium all over. 所以呢，现在呢，我们就整个表面呢都涂上裂纹剂，就是这个裂剂，整个你要确保有涂上就可以，不要涂到太薄。Not too thin, okay? Try to be slightly thicker. You see, my brush always look a lot of cracker medium. 你可以看到我的笔呢，每次都拿了很多、很多的那个劣迹，这样子。Okay, just all over. Then we blow dry. Take some time to blow. You have to make sure it's very dry. So the best result is if you can leave it one day.Okay, 所以呢，然后你要吹干，你要确保它非常非常的干。它最好的效果呢，就是如果你可以等一天让它自然干透，效果是最好。但是你没有等一天呢，也是 OK 的，但是你要确保它非常的干。If you have no time to wait, you have no patience to wait for one day, it's fine. But you have to make sure it's totally dry, okay, before you apply the paint. Okay, so you see, I already applyAll over the surface. 你看我整个表面都已经把它涂满了。然后呢，我就要不要再重叠哦。一些地方已经要干的地方不要再重叠。Don't overlap at the place that you already apply the crackle. Okay, like that. 就是这样子就 OK 了。然后我们吹干。Now I have spent some time to blow dry first. 所以呢，我要花一点时间呢，先把它吹干。 Okay, I already spent some time to blow dry. 我花了一点时间来把它吹到很干很干。It's totally very dry and let it cool down first. 然后我等它冷却。现在呢，我要把颜色拍上去。现在呢，我们就拍上颜色。Now we have to apply the color. And I want to use again the vintage blue, antique white. But this project, I want to add a little bit of the soft yellow.我想就是用这两个颜色延伸我之前用的都是用很多这个蓝色和这个古典的白色 OK 古典蓝和还有这个白色然后呢我今天想加一个就是这个浅浅的黄色 OK get ready the paint first 先把我们的颜料先准备好The spun, okay, the dauber. And the main color I want to use for this project is these two. 我最重要的这两个颜色呢要用在这件作品呢就是蓝和这个古典白 is the antique white and the vintage blue. So, you have to mix the color first that you want, but don't blend too well. You still can see blue, you still can see white. 你先把颜色你要的颜色先混合一下但是呢你还是可以看到蓝还是可以看到白。所以就把它拍上去。So after you dab, you don't dab over because it start crackling, you see? 然后你拍了过后呢你不要再在这个地方再拍因为它已经开始裂了。当它开始裂的时候你把它拍上去那个裂缝就给你遮住了。So if when it start crackling and you dab again, then the crack will cover by your paint, okay? So you don't dab over.So sometimes I want to add a little bit of the yellow.So you have to blend, when you want to blend the color, you have to dab it very gently. 如果你要把颜色混在一起呢，你就要轻一点。You see, it start crackling, can see? 它已经开始裂了，开始裂我们就不拍颜色，所以你看这里呢，我就颜色没有混到。刚才讲话的时候颜色没有混到就没有这么好看 because just now I keep talking and I didn't blend well the color, you see the color is not blending so nice.So you just keep dabbing and you have to make sure the color is blending well. 然后呢你要是要注意一下颜色呢你要调的是差不多类似。可以拍的时候呢它是可以有连贯性的。So the color can be connect, okay? So I better put my hand inside. So have to prepare your color first. 先把颜色你要的颜色呢先准备好比较好。So or else halfway you have no paint then easy for you to take the paint again and it start crackling. 不然的话呢你做到一半的时候呢颜色没有了你要再倒颜色的时候呢就比较难因为它已经开始裂了。你可以看到有时候呢我要颜色调和在一起的时候呢我就拍得比较轻。As you can see, sometimes I want the color blending together, I will dab it slightly lighter. So,See, I not prepare well. My color have to put the blue again. 所以我的颜色不够，先放点蓝。So just all over. So if you have no confidence and you are first time doing this one, I suggest you don't do so many colors. Just that I like to blend. I like to use different color tone. I don't want a mono color.OK, 但是呢我觉得初学者呢我还是建议你呢最好呢你就不要先尝试这么多颜色的混合。你最好呢就是先尝试一个颜色到你已经习惯了你已经大概知道抓到那个技巧了你就可以试试混色。OK, so I suggest you to do a single color first for the beginner if you're first time doing the crackle effect.如果你真的是第一次做这个裂纹的效果的呢我真的是建议你先做一个颜色 Just dab all over, then blow dry, and we will see how's the result. 先整体把它先拍完然后呢我们就来看看它的效果我先把它整个拍完。Okay, you see done already, and I blow dry with the hair dryer. When you blow dry, you use the hair dryer to force it dry, it will crack more.如果你用吹风机现在我们用吹风机来吹呢就强迫它干它会裂得更多我们来看看 You see, after dry, actually is very, very nice crab, okay? 看吹干了过后呢，你可以看到它的裂纹是很好看的。现在呢，我们就会来上两层的亮光保护剂，就保护这个我们已经做好的这个处理背景处理。So we will apply two layers of water-based varnish to protect the whole surface that we already do the crackle. Okay, this one is the water-based varnish. You can use any varnish that you have. Do not mix water.Just apply all over for a very good protection. Then when you do later when you decoupage, then easier to clean the extra glue. And also if anything happened on the surface, you can easily wipe off. 这层的保护剂呢是非常重要的，因为等一下呢你不小心沾到颜料呢，它是很容易清理的。OK, 所以呢我们就大概要涂上两层。It's good that you can apply two layers of the varnish, okay? Then each layer blow dry, then we continue the next step. 每一层要吹干，然后呢，我们就进行下一个步骤。如果你觉得有一点太干了，你可以加一点点水。If you found that the varnish is very, very thick, you can add a little bit of water, but not too much, okay? Because it's water-based, you can always add the water together.How to add the water, okay. So here is the water, 这样加水 I just add like this, and also the varnish, not so much. Just like that, then blow dry, two layers, okay. 就是这样子，沾一点点水，然后再用这个，再拿这个亮光保护剂上涂上去就可以了。两层，每一层吹干，然后我们就接续。Okay, after two layers of the varnish, you see it's a bit shining.涂了两层亮光保护剂呢，其实你可以看到它也是有点发亮的。现在呢，我就想，贴上这个水转印子。So if you know me, you know that I like to use the water slide. I want my project have some wording to make it stand out. 所以呢，我的作品呢，我很喜欢放一些字体，让它更凸显那些图纸。所以呢，这件作品也是一样延伸我自己的风格。So same as this project, I want to extend my, still the continue with my own style. So the water slide paper you can put here and you can dab with the water. But because the surface is not flat, so I will like to soak into the water. 因为呢它的这个不平嘛，它的表面不平，平时呢你可以就是这样子铺着，然后你拍那个水上来就可以了，就是 dab using the wet sponge. But this one I want to just soak into the water. So in this project I'm using this paper. Show you. 我用的是这一张。I'm using this paper. I'm using another paper. This one is a water slide. It just cut out the image you want. 我用的是另外一个图纸，就是把它剪出来你要的款式。这边呢都有我们的步骤。All the instructions here, and also if you're not sure, you can scan the code, can scan the QR code, and you can check the tutorial. 如果你不熟悉呢，你也可以扫描二维码，你也可以看到那个视频。So just soak into the water, 先把它泡在水里面，等到那个图纸跟那个白色的底纸呢分离就可以了。Just wait until the image is separated from the paper.Usually around 10 to 40 seconds. Sometimes it's 40 to 60, but now it's maybe shorter, maybe 10 to 20 seconds. 有时候呢会大概10到20秒，上次呢就大概是40到60秒。现在我就觉得它很快就已经 OK 了。You see? Okay? You can soak a while. 再泡多一下。然后呢这个的图纸呢 in this project,I'm using the paper series, is this series, KAD02. 我用的是这两个，这两张纸的混合。And also KAD12, I mix these two paper. And the paper you have to cut in very detail using a special scissor to make your cutting easier. You can check my other tutorial, I share very clearly. 这个图纸呢，你要剪到非常仔细，okay?所以呢就要用一个比较好的剪刀，这样子呢你剪的时候呢就会比较省时间省功夫。 OK, so I will using these two paper, that's why I using a little bit of yellow color. 所以呢为什么我会加了一点黄，因为看到这个纸有一点黄色，所以也加了一点黄色进来。 So OK, ready, I lift up. You can see the paper already separated. 你可以看到它已经分离了，对不对？ 然后呢我们就现在把它铺上来，铺在我们的那个玻璃瓶上。 So now we just put on the glass. Here. Okay, fix the position first. I think it's here. 就是大概这个位置，然后呢就把它拿掉就可以了。 You see, very simple. Spread. And use the kitchen towel, the dry cloth.To wipe off the extra water. 然后呢就用一个干的纸巾或者是那个布呢就把多余的水分擦掉。如果你觉得有一点那个，如果有发觉有一点皱纹呢，你也可以用手这样子铺。 If you found that there's some wrinkle, you also can spread using your finger like this, but you have to make sure the paper still wet, or you can put some water on your finger to spread like this to make it smooth. 你也可以手指呢沾点水，然后呢让它这样子更加平滑。 Make sure you still have water before you do this one, okay? See? Very nice. 这样子就很好看了。 See? 然后呢我们就会拿那个布 to clean the extra water. 就是这样子把那个多余的水分擦掉。 Then blow dry. After blow dry, actually, I will also varnish 1 to 2 layers to protect this paper first before I do decoupage.擦干了吹干了过后呢，我也会上两层的亮光保护剂，先保护这张纸，然后我才做拼贴。 Okay, I already varnished 2 layers of the varnish. Okay, so I want to use this paper. It's the same series of this. Okay, so I want to put like this. You can do your arrangement. I don't want to cover so much of my water slide, so maybe I want to do like this.因为我不想遮掉太多我这个水转印纸，所以呢我可能要这样子。 You can do any arrangement you want. Okay, yeah. You also can change to other papers. If this one I found that maybe it's a bit bulky, a bit big. So you see, if like this is nice also, just depends on which kind of paper that you like. 这张也蛮美的，只是看一下你要如何去设计。 Okay, so I just share, I will use only this paper and share with you howI like this kind of water slide paper. Why? Because it's transparent and you can see through the techniques that you are doing, the background technique. Then you can have any background technique that you have. Okay? 我喜欢这样子透明的水转印纸，因为这样子呢才可以看到你的背景处理嘛，才可以看到你做的很好看的背景处理，因为它是透明的。 Okay, so how to glue? I would like to use this mixed media glue because I found that this glue is very, very good.So I apply on the whole surface. So my arrangement, the paper like this one, you see the wing is the stem here is very thin. So I have no choice. We have to leave some white color. So later we will touch up with the paint. 因为这个它的这个梗呢，这个树枝呢，其实它有一点太细了，我没有办法剪到很细，然后呢它会断。 Okay, so it will break if I cut really close to it.所以呢我等下呢我们做完了过后呢我们就用颜色来把它补上去。 Then after we finish, we'll touch up with the color. Okay, so maybe I want the arrangement like this. 我要想要这样子的，这样子的铺排。我先就先上那个就大概是这个范围。 So around this area I will apply the mixed media glue on the surface, 就是把它涂在这个玻璃上，而不是涂在纸。 It's not on the paper. That's why I said why we need to protect the surface with the varnish. If the extra glue later, we can clean easily. 所以为什么呢？我们会先上一层两层的那个亮光保护剂。如果有什么问题，或者是肮脏，等下那个胶水呢 ？I mean 这个拼贴胶呢也比较容易清理。And then if you're not using the brush, you have to soak in immediately into the water, or else very hard to wash. 那个笔呢，不用呢，要马上先泡水。不然等一下非常难洗。然后呢现在呢先把它吹干。 So have to blow dry first. After blow dry is still sticky, so it's easier for you to glue the paper. So now 吹干了过后呢其实它还是黏黏的哈，所以你要确保你的手指是没有黏哦。 You have to make sure that your finger is not sticky, eh? So I just now I have to put on the paper. 先把纸先放上来，就是从一边慢慢放。 So you just put from one side to the other side. Don't go down every part immediately, so that you have the bubble have place to go out. 所以呢那个气泡嘛才有地方放，才有地方 走出来，所以呢你要慢慢一点点的铺。 So have to slowly from one part to the other part。You see, my finger won't touch here because here very sticky. If you accidentally, if too sticky, you will peel off the paint. 因为太黏了，你看我的手指尽量就不动到这里，不然的话呢，太黏了，我怕黏的时候呢，会把我们的这一层那个颜料呢给我扒上来。Okay.Then now what we do, we have to clean the extra glue with the wet cloth. 所以呢，现在呢，我们要做的呢，就是用那个湿的布把多余的那个胶呢，拼贴胶呢，把它擦掉。Have to wipe out, wipe to the outer part. 就是这样子把它擦出来，不要擦进去。Don't go in, go in, you will spoil the paper. Okay, 就是这样子把它往外。Okay.So important that you have to make sure no glue on the surface, because after some time, after dry, after some time you varnish, the glue will pop up. 因为不然的呢，过了一个时期过后呢，如果你没有清干净呢，那个白色的那个拼贴胶呢，它会浮上来，就不好看了。Okay, just clean like that, then blow dry and varnish, then done.就是这样子呢，然后我们上了两层、两三层 ，at least three layers of the varnish, then done. Each layer have to blow dry. 当然，每一层也是要吹干才涂第二层。我先把它吹干 ，so I blow dry first, and I show you the next step. 吹干了，然后我再分享你我们下一个步骤。After blow dry, you can use a scraper here at the corner.To smooth out the extra bubble and the wrinkles, 你就可以用这个刮板呢，用这里就是这样子把它刮平。然后呢，我们现在就上那个亮光保护剂。And now I can apply few layers of the varnish. Then done, 就完成了。Okay, varnish 就是这个亮光保护剂，就是这样子涂上来，不要加水。Don't mix with water.Just like that. You see, it glued very nicely, very flat and very smooth. 你可以看到它粘得很服帖的，就是这样。Okay, you can also varnish all over, also or only on the paper, at least three layers. But the best is you can apply all over for three layers. Each layer blow dry, then done. 每一层吹干呢就完成了。Okay.Very simple and nice project. 其实是蛮简单的一个作品。吹干了过后呢，你也是还是可以用刮板。Each time after you blow dry, you still can use the scraper to make it more smooth. 用刮板呢，让它更平滑。就是这样子，吹干就做第二层、第三层。So after blow dry, you apply second layer and third layer and completed. Hope you like today's project.You can share it to your friends and give me a like. 希望你喜欢今天的作品，你可以分享给你的朋友，你也可以给我一个赞。Thank you.